गुड मॉर्निंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, माई सिंसियर थैंक टू डॉक्टर विपुल गुप्ता एंड हिज टीम टू इन्वाइट मी एंड गिविंग मी ऑनर टू स्पीक ऑन अ वेरी रिलेवेंट टॉपिक, हाइड्रोक्सीक्लोरोक्विन मिथ्स एंड रियलिटी। एज ए फिजिशियन वी ऑल नो दिस ड्रग, वेदर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ original quinine or chloroquine and now hydroxychloroquine, it is used for malaria. The facts are, I am first giving the facts of the history. First time this drug was used by people knew that a fever which comes with chills and rigors, so called malaria, was treated by bark of a tree. And first time in 1600 century, the Peru king, the king of Peru, he used this drug, he used this bark for his princes, and then it became more popular. But the most authentic report is from our own country, when Tipu Sultan was defeated by Britishers and his soldiers captured the fort, but they were dying of a disease called malaria, and so they were surprised that so much rampant malaria is there, what to do? So locals suggested use of this powder they were using, the same bark tree, and they started using it. And very interesting story, since it was so bitter that soldiers refused to take that, and few people were not taking it. So the Britishers, very intelligently, they started mixing it with syrup and gin, and they called it gin syrup. So the popular came as a gin syrup came into. So that is how. Even I served in army for 40 years, and I can tell you, there are more soldiers died of malaria than the bullets. If you read the Burma campaign, the Britishers, the more people died of malaria. Even if you go today to Calcutta and visit Fort William Library, there are a lot of stones which are marked as Captain so-and-so, Captain so-and-so, Major so-and-so died of malaria. So people were dying of malaria. So more people died of malaria than bullets. And Britishers introduced strict quinine parade or chloroquine parade, where people will line up and every week they have to use the drug as a prophylaxis. When I joined army in 1977, till 80s, I have seen Indian army using the same trick that they were doing. They were giving chloroquine to their soldiers as a prophylaxis for malaria. So these are the facts about then who are the maximum user, and this is called malaria parade. So people were made to stand in line, and in front of an officer that malaria tablet is taken. That is called malaria parade. Even in northeast, probably it is still there. Who are the maximum user of this drug, whether in the form of chloroquine or hydroxychloroquine, is V means rheumatologist. I am a rheumatologist. Rheumatologists write about 1 crore prescriptions. These facts I have taken from the drug industry, that about 1 crore prescriptions are of this drug is generated in this country. It only shows the safety. We checked from the Indian Rheumatology Association and from other publications that the side effects of this drug is very, very rare. So another fact is side effects are rare. Despite the myth that it increases the QT prolongation, and who tells about these side effects more? Cardiologist. And what is their basis? Their basis is just 41 case reports. So just 41 case reports, they say this drug is unsafe. While this drug is very safe, that is what we rheumatologists know when we generate 1 crore prescription every month. So, but even now, even we are cautious what we do. If we are using these drugs for rheumatoid arthritis, SLE and other diseases, we know it is safe, but every drug has a side effect. So the dyspepsia and prolonged uses may cause retinopathy and skin pigmentation, darkening of skin tone and sometimes diarrhea. So it is probably the long-term uses which has a concern. In any case, because safety remains the paramount thing, ICMR, because of the so much pressure, they did include that once at least ECG should be done. Though as a rheumatologist, we have not a single rheumatologist has told the patient to get an ECG done before the hydroxychloroquine, because we know it is safe and QT prolongation is very, very rare and hardly any case of ventricular tachycardia. So it is more of a theoretical concern than practical. So that is about the safety part. Now, how it came to use in COVID? What happened in 2004? SARC virus, there was no drug for SARC virus, and NIH and other people, they were working that they must find a drug for the SARC virus. So they tested many drugs as an antiviral property. Chloroquine was one, remsidivir was another, and a few other antiviral drugs, favipiravir and other. And in that, in 2004 itself, they found hydroxychloroquine is more, chloroquine is more effective than other drugs. So that that evidence we had from 2004, the first is when the epidemic occurred in China in December, the Chinese didn't know what to do. So they were using common drugs, but then what they did, they started using, because of 2004 evidence of SARC virus, they started using hydroxychloroquine, and they summarized, the first study was published from China in March, and this was published on 20th of March, and that was a retrospective analysis that yes, it definitely reduces the mortality if use of hydroxychloroquine. That was the first. So after that, many studies were published. The most powerful study which was published was a French study. It had more than 1,000 patients, and this was the author was Matthew, and the place was Marshlin, and they proved that in this retrospective analysis of a huge data of 1,000 patients, hydroxychloroquine reduces the mortality of the and hospital stay, and it also make the seropositive to the positive people to the negative as when they do the testing. So it was effective. So that was happening, but so there were two studies. One is Chinese studies, which says it was a retrospective, non-randomized, non-controlled study, that it is effective. Then the French study and few Italian studies. That was happening in March. Before that, my own experience, personal experience, that I went to Dhaka on 10th of March to attend a rheumatology conference, and in the television, the fellow, they invited us, there was people from France, people from Spain, and 2-3 UK, USA, and me. So this was an international conference of rheumatology. So the TV people, Dhaka people, they invited us, and they started asking more on COVID rather than rheumatology. And frankly speaking, on 10th March, I didn't know much about COVID. So I said, we don't have any case of COVID in our country. So the anchor was very smart. He said, "No, you have 30 cases of COVID in your country." So I said, "Oh, yes, probably they are from Kerala. They are imported students." So that is how I was little stimulated about COVID. By the time I came to India, I realized the airport, a lot of checking is going on, and people are so our country also got probably sensitized. And then came the lockdown. And I started running temperature. That time there was hardly any lab except one or two labs which were doing the testing. And I was very sure that probably maybe I developed COVID or something. I don't know what it was, but I was having fever and loss of taste, fatigue, myalgia. I didn't know whether it was a travel or because of, but since I had mild fever, so I read about this drug, hydroxychloroquine, from the Chinese studies and French study because they were already in the print. And I wrote a WhatsApp message to all my friends that this is my personal view based on these two studies that if COVID is there in this country, we should use hydroxychloroquine as a therapeutic dose and maybe also in the prophylaxis, but that is my own personal view. That WhatsApp message went to a lot of my friends, including the health secretary, which replied to me that this your personal message I am forwarding to ICMR. I developed cold feet because I always thought it is not for ICMR. I just wrote my view as a personal view. That was on 20 March. On 22nd of March, ICMR issued guidelines that hydroxychloroquine can be used. So at least I can take a little credit that yes, I wrote a WhatsApp message and ICMR rightfully considered it. And then they went into the literature search and they issued a guidelines that who can use the hydroxychloroquine and who should not use. They only caution about yes, about the QT prolongation and the ECG. So the reality is, yes, the ICMR agreed that hydroxychloroquine can be used both for prophylaxis and both for treatment. Then, of course, the war started between the then hydroxychloroquine. India is the biggest producer of hydroxychloroquine. So every country was initial reaction was they were very scared that what will happen, thousands of people will die. People were dying in thousands in America and in Spain and Italy. So they thought, okay, if hydroxychloroquine is a magic drug, let's have it. And you like a typical America reaction, the Trump wanted and pressurized our country that you must export hydroxychloroquine because government had banned by the time export of hydroxychloroquine. Earlier, I checked from the company. The companies who were making hydroxychloroquine, they were telling we used to sell about 1 crore tablets every month, and that production went up to 3 crore. So you can imagine how much it was used, how much it is being used. As on today, I can tell you there is not a single case of COVID where hydroxychloroquine is not used. So people are convinced that yes, probably there is a commercial war between hydroxychloroquine versus rest. So then comes the another drug, remdesivir. Now, it's not that remdesivir is a bad drug, but certainly it is an inferior drug than hydroxychloroquine. But since remdesivir was manufactured by a Gillette company from US, and they started pressurizing that let's come in competition with the hydroxychloroquine. So there are some studies was published, negative studies on hydroxychloroquine. Out of that, the biggest study was Lancet. And Lancet studied practically said that hydroxychloroquine is useless. It is neither for prophylaxis nor for treatment, and in fact it increases the mortality. And then There are the two, three studies published in New England Journal of Medicine, Western media. And gradually, as the Indian doctors, we realize probably something is fishy. So we wrote to Lancet that, look, your study has a fault because you have used hydroxychloroquine only in serious cases. In any case, they were dying. So don't blame hydroxychloroquine for that. In any case, then came the editorial of Lancet and they withdrew this study. And they accepted that they were under pressure. So you can imagine, ladies and gentlemen, in real world, your personal experience is more important than published studies. Published studies have a legal sanctity. I don't say all the published studies are bad, but 50-50 chances are there today that if I'm a businessman and I own remdesivir and I want my drug should be popular, then I'll purchase some writers and they will use it. That exactly what has happened. And then we came to know that remdesivir people, they paid that doctor to write, and that is how called paid publication. We all know that there are good and bad things about publication. Real world also has a problem, but if so many people are telling hydroxychloroquine goes good, then it is good. So my own personal view is, and ICMR also feel, that it is a good drug. Now, the realities. So, reality number one is it is safe drug. That is number one. Now, this reality, all scientists and all physicians has to keep in mind. And who's telling it is safe? Rheumatologists. And how they are telling? Because we are writing 1 crore prescription every month. So, it is a safe drug. What about the cardiac toxicity? Extremely rare, only 41 published cases are there, and extremely rare. We have not seen. About ECG, yes, the statutory warning is you must get one ECG during course of time, so you can get a ECG done also. Otherwise, our own view is we have never got a ECG done, but ICMR recommends use of ECG. Efficacy, the initial reports of SARC virus, which was done by NIH, that hydroxychloroquine is effective. Then two studies, one China, another from the France. Initially in the March itself, a retrospective analysis was done that hydroxychloroquine is effective. And our own ICMR study says that hydroxychloroquine is effective. So reality is, it is effective. What about negative studies, those so-called control studies? Probably they have to be seen with the pinch of salt, with the remdesivir on the another drug on competition. A good trial, multi-center, multinational, good control trial by honest people are required. ICMR and another trial by WHO and another trial by UK. It is already on way. And maybe the time will tell hydroxychloroquine is a real queen drug, a real drug, or we have probably it is just on the basis of some uncontrolled trial we are using it. As on today, the reality is hydroxychloroquine is here to stay. Safety part, efficacy part, then is the uses, the prophylaxis part. Now, since there is no other drug for prophylaxis, the ICMR recommends it that the healthcare workers, initially it was only for healthcare workers, then came the frontline workers, that it should be used initially 400 milligram BD, then 200 milligram, 200 milligram. The 200 milligram weekly and should be used. That is a prophylaxis dose. Most of the people are using it. Initially, it was recommended for 7 to 8 weeks, but people are continuing. For contacts, it is for about 3 weeks. It is safe. They do recommend ECG. What are the contraindication? It should not be used. If somebody has a heart problem, they should get a clearance from the cardiologist. If somebody has a retinopathy, and somebody is allergic to hydroxychloroquine, then it should not be used. So, ladies and gentlemen, before I close, I must tell you the few studies, because we are physicians and we must go with what happened from the December. So December was the 31st December, the China reported that they have a epidemic of coronavirus, and then in March came the first study. So I'll read out because I can't remember. The first study came on 20th March. It was published in International Journal of Antimicrobial Agent, and it was a positive study that it supported use of hydroxychloroquine. Then, of course, the French study, which I was talking about, it was published in Travel Medicine and Infectious Disease. That came on 5th of May. Then is the Lancet study, which I always told you, that also came on 22nd May. So fast it came, you can imagine. On 27 May, the WHO, there's a trial going on, Solidarity trial, which is WHO had withdrawn hydroxychloroquine. They say it should not be used. And then came a lot of hue and cry. We also wrote to the WHO, and they retracted their the WHO the Lancet, when they retracted their study on 3rd of June, and hydroxychloroquine the WHO started using they reinstated the hydroxychloroquine. So on 3rd June, NEJM again published an article that hydroxychloroquine is not effective. And on 1st of July, recently, International Journal of Infectious Diseases, SAMIA, published a good article that it definitely reduces the mortality. A very good study. Ongoing trials are there. The largest ongoing trial which is going on is it's called as COV trial. It's a UK-based multinational trial from Africa, Asia, and South Asia. It's a placebo-controlled 3 months trial and 40,000 health workers. Let's see what happens. And of course, ICMR ongoing trial of thousands health workers. Initially, it was 12-week trial, which results are already there, and it was published in Indian Journal of Medicine on 13 June, and they say it's a significant decline in the odd ratio of getting infected. So the even American physicians, the American Association of Physicians, they also made a lot of hullabaloo to the Trump that hydroxychloroquine is effective, and earlier FDA has banned it. Now FDA has again revoked that it can be used. So probably there are a lot of myths, and so I think practically I have come to the end of the talk that we really don't know hydroxychloroquine is efficacious or not. There are 50-50 chances that hydroxychloroquine is effective. My own view, personal view, after seeing the detailed literature search, I feel the balance is more in favor of hydroxychloroquine, that yes, it is effective against COVID. It may not be the last drug. Few more good, better drugs will come. A better vaccine will come. But as on today, the balance is in favor of hydroxychloroquine. It is more effective than remdesivir. Remdesivir is an IV drug. This is an oral drug. We have a large experience of hydroxychloroquine for many years, almost 300 to 400 years. We know it's a safe drug. Safe because rheumatologists uses it maximum, so we know it is safer. So this one, we are very sure about it, and this is a fact. There's no myth about it, that it is a safe drug. Role of prophylaxis, Indian and ICMR way, probably we are continuing with that, and till the very good trial comes that if it's substantiate, ICMR feel it is effective. It should be used judiciously, that if somebody has a cardiac issue or something, yes, one ECG, there's no harm in doing ECG, and comorbidity should be tested. So, ladies and gentlemen, I have come to the end of it. I feel till a better drug is available, hydroxychloroquine should be used for coronavirus, both for prophylaxis and for treatment. It is a safe drug. Because of commercial interest of many people, a lot of unnecessary muck was published against this drug. Probably there are very good trials which are already available that yes, it is an effective drug. It decreases the mortality, it decreases the hospital stay, it prevents the hospital, it prevents the cytokine storm, and how it works probably at multiple level. When the coronavirus get attached to the cell, to the receptor, it works there. So it prevents coronavirus entry into the cell. Then it increases the pH of lysozyme. So the antigen presentation is hampered and it prevents the replication of virus. So scientifically also, that hydroxychloroquine has a clear-cut evidence that it does acts as an antiviral. It may not be the last drug, a more better drug will come, but till then, hydroxychloroquine, we use it and all of us use it. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks.